Podcast Bites.
So basically, for people listening that want to know how the study worked, they took three groups of people, and gave everybody antibiotics, massive doses of Cipro and metronidazole. Then they gave one group probiotics.
I hope they paid the study participants for that.
Yeah. They gave one group probiotics. They let the other group just recover spontaneously, what they called watchful waiting. Mm-hmm. And they gave the third group actually FMT of their own stool injected back up inside rectally.
A fecal microbiota transplant.
Autologous. So their own original community. And they wanted to test the hypothesis what's the fastest way of returning back to your normal baseline, to the exact alpha diversity of your microbiome before you took the antibiotics?
Take a probiotic, don't do anything, or shove your crap back
up. Shove it right back up in there. Yeah. So first of all, forgetting about the limitations of shoving your crap back up commercially, look at all three groups. At 90 days, everything lost statistical significance. Everything. So that means that the recovery, whether you took probiotics, whether you took an FMT, or whether you just did nothing at all, at 90 days, all three groups were indistinguishable from one another.
Meaning indistinguishable, that it didn't change their bacterial profile.
Meaning you couldn't pick which person was in which group after 90 days because the error bars were all overlapping. And so, for all intents and purposes, the paper should have said 10 species are delayed for up to 90 days on probiotics, but we don't know by how much. I mean, but that's much less exciting of a paper than saying probiotics delay the gut microbiome recovery.
Avocado, motherfucker.